Hey guys, today we're diving into the world of web design. From the fundamentals to advanced techniques and all the best tools out there to help you get the job done. So get comfortable, grab a cup of coffee and stay tuned. Hey, I'm Amy, and whether you're new to web design or just need a little refresher, I'm going to break down everything you need to know to design a beautiful and, more importantly, functional website. So let's get started. So first of all, what exactly is web design? It's basically the planning and arranging of content on a website. It's like digital interior design where aesthetics meet functionality, and you decide what your site will look like from the colors to the fonts, graphics, and all the little details that'll shape the user experience. And here's the thing, since everything is online these days, if you want to make any kind of impact, you've got to have a killer website. Because of this, the world of web design is as dynamic as ever. It's constantly evolving, adding in things like mobile apps and user interface design to meet the constantly changing needs of site owners and visitors. Okay, before we go any further, let's talk about the difference between web design and website development, because people don't always know, and I think it's an important distinction. When we talk about web design, we're talking about the look and feel of a site. It's where we focus on creating a great user experience and making things visually appealing. Website development, on the other hand, is more about the technical stuff, building and maintaining the structure of a site, usually using code. HTML and CSS are languages used by developers to determine the structure and the style of a web page. And even if you aren't sure what they actually are, you probably heard the terms before. So let's talk about them for a second. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It creates the front end of a site, kind of like the skeleton that gives structure to the page. CSS, which stands for Cascading Style Sheets, is another language that works with HTML to make websites look good and polished. It's all about things like fonts and layouts. There's also something called a CMS, which is a software application that helps manage the digital content of a site. That means you don't need to know code at all. And Wix, by the way, is a great example of a CMS. It's really user-friendly and basically does the programming for you behind the scenes. We touched on the tools people use for developing sites, but what about for designing? Because you definitely need the right tools to be able to design exactly the way you want. Here are a few questions you need to ask yourself. What's the purpose of your website? What's the overall look and feel you're going for? What kind of budget do you have? What kind of technical requirements does your site have? Will you create an adaptive or responsive design? And how big is your team? The answer to these are going to help you understand what kind of website builder is best for you. And site builders like Wix are great because they come with a ton of ready-made templates for every industry. And you don't even need to know how to code. Plus, they give you everything you need to publish your site and get online fast, like reliable hosting and the ability to buy a domain name. You've also got other design software tools that help you make things like wireframes, custom features, and design elements. But the problem with them is that you'll usually need to convert the elements to code, so while you do get a lot of creative flexibility and cool collaboration features, they might take a bit more time, resources, and background knowledge. As you play around with these tools, you'll figure out which ones you like best and which work best for your projects. Okay, let's dive into the actual principles of design itself. These are the guidelines that artists and designers stick to create beautiful compositions. And they aren't strict rules, but keeping them in mind can seriously amp up the look and feel of any site. So let's break them down. First, balance. This means making sure that none of the elements are too overpowering. Do this by arranging elements so that the visual weight is equal on both sides. Contrast. Think dark versus light or large versus small. Contrast adds drama and excitement to your website, drawing in visitors as they scroll through. Emphasis. Here, we focus on highlighting key elements to guide the viewer's attention, whether it's your logo, a call to action button, or an image you want to make sure really stands out. Movement. By controlling the size, direction, and order of elements, you create a sense of flow and motion, which will help you control where your viewer's attention is focused throughout your site. Rhythm. It's all about repetition and establishing a visual beat or pattern. You should repeat elements like your logo, brand colors, or typography to strengthen your brand identity and make your site more memorable. Hierarchy. or organizing elements based on importance. You want to make sure the most important elements are at the top spots where they won't be missed. White space. Using empty space to enhance clarity and focus will give your visual elements room to breathe. And finally, unity. Making sure that all your elements work together cohesively so that visitors feel drawn in and engaged instead of overwhelmed or confused. It may take a few tries to figure out what you like and what works for you, so pay attention to what you use, where you're putting it, and why, and make sure that everything is actually serving a purpose. Planning the layout of your website is all about figuring out how you want to arrange and organize everything on the page. This step is super important because it'll dictate how easy it is for people to use and how your message comes across. When it comes to finding the best layout for your specific website, you've got to consider a few things. First, what's the purpose of your site? And what kind of content will you have? Like, are you selling products? In which case, you'd want to have plenty of space for awesome product images. Or are you running a blog? Because then you'd want to make sure your layout is super organized and easy to navigate, so your readers can find everything they're looking for. If you're not sure where to start, I'd suggest taking a look at Wix's website templates. They're made by designers, so they look good, but even more than that, they're built strategically after lots of research to make sure they're user-friendly and have all the best practices built in for every type of site. Okay, let's talk functionality. It's a really important aspect of web design because it's all about how your site works, from its speed to the actions you can perform on it. And these days, we've got so many tools at our disposal to make sure our sites perform well and are user-friendly. So let's dive into some key tools that'll really make a difference for your site. Navigation. When visitors arrive at your site, they need to be able to easily find what they're looking for. You can use different kinds of menus to do that, like the classic menu in the header, sticky menus that stay fixed in place as you scroll, hamburger menus, drop-down menus, or sidebar menus. Speed is crucial in today's fast-paced world. No one likes or will stay on a slow website. Studies show that if a web page takes more than 3 seconds to load, bounce rates increase by 38%. SEO. This is the process of optimizing your website to rank well on search engines, and it's important because the more visible you are on platforms like Google, the more visitors you'll attract. UX is about making your website easy to use and navigate. It focuses on interactions, content, products, services, and overall usability. And of course, adaptive design. Since most people are going online on their phones, iPads, or other mobile devices, it's super important that your site looks great and functions well on different screen sizes or browser widths. All right, I know this was a quick overview, so if you want to know more about any of these, I'll link our full blog post in the description where you can read a bit more. When you go to a new site that you've never seen before, what's the first thing you do? Like most people, you probably skim it over, scroll through it, and take in the whole picture to decide if you actually want to read it. And that's why when building your own site, the visual elements are so important. Everything from the header to the footer establishes the tone and affects how or if viewers will experience your site. So you've got to make them good. So what are the main visual elements? You've got the header and footer, colors, typography, background, imagery, and animation. The header is, of course, the top section of the web page and the first thing people will see. It's usually where you've got your navigation menu, business name, logo, or contact information. The footer is the part all the way at the bottom. It stays fixed on any internal pages, like if you have a separate About Me page. It's a really good place to add anything important like contact details, a map, or social media buttons. Colors. How do you choose the right ones that'll not only work well together, but also represent your product in the right way? You should for sure use colors that match your branding or logo. And you can check out color wheels online that'll show you what colors work together and what will just clash. Also, look into color psychology. You'll learn a lot, like that purple is the color of luxury, or that blue is actually the most used color on the internet and represents calm, peace, and intelligence, which is probably why it's used for huge company logos like Facebook and LinkedIn. Next up, typography. This is your font choices and text arrangement. You should use fonts that are readable, align with your style, and of course are on brand. Your site's background is also really important. I know it might seem like it wouldn't really matter, but it actually sets the tone and covers your entire site, so it's pretty important. You can play around with it though. Go with something static or animated, solid or textured. Just keep it interesting and not too overwhelming. The imagery on your site can also be a really powerful tool. You can choose from free stock content on site building platforms, Wix has a ton, or upload your own. And animation. This is a great way to make your site pop and look good, but it's also a cool way to create dynamic and engaging experience for your viewers. Animate important elements like your CTAs, arrows, loading bars, anything you really want your visitors to pay attention to. Once you publish your initial design, you'll eventually need to update your website to keep the content relevant and the design fresh. Trust me, having outdated elements on your site can totally mess up your visitors' experience and hurt your overall performance. So make it a habit to check on your site at least once a month, just to make sure everything works smoothly and your info is up to date. Maybe change up or add some cool visuals, an extra page, work on your SEO, and don't forget about accessibility. Okay, so now you're technically ready to start working on your own site. But before you jump in, here's a pro tip. Find inspiration. Seriously, it can make a world of difference. And the best part is, inspiration is literally all around you. You don't have to look that far to find great ideas. And here at Wix, we're always keeping an eye out for the latest web design trends and incredible sites created by our super talented users. It's really inspiring to see how they bring their unique ideas to life using our platform. And we're so proud to showcase their work. So I'll throw a few links in the description where you can check some of them out. All right, that's a wrap for today. I hope you found this video helpful and you feel ready to get out there and start your site. And if you want more information about anything I've covered here, just check out our blog post where we dive deeper into all the details. And don't forget to check out the description for all the links I've added for you. And of course, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more great content. See ya!